In this video, we are going to take a look at the creation of holes using the hole tool in Autodesk Inventor. It is possible to essentially create a hole by sketching a circle and then extruding it as a cut. However, there's many benefits in using the actual hole tool instead. One of the benefits that we don't see quite yet, but we will later, is when we go to place a part onto a drawing. We will have a hole note tool that we can use to pull in information such as, does it have a countersink, a counterbore, what is the depth of the hole, is it a threaded hole, what are the thread specifications. So there's a lot of benefit drawing wise for us to use the hole tool. But then there's also some benefits model wise, including the ability to add countersinks and counterbores, and then of course the threads as well. First, let's look at some different methods for placing a hole. I'll start with the hole tool. And it's not real obvious when you start the hole command, but what you want to do is click three things. You want to start by clicking on the face that your hole is going to go on. Then you want to click on a reference that you want to dimension off of and then enter a value. And then a second reference and enter a value. So let's say that I wanted to place a hole in here and it was going to be a half an inch off of each side. My first click will be somewhere on this top face. My next click then will be one of the edges I want to dimension off of. So I'll select this edge here, then type in a value. But I won't press enter because I want to go in and pick a second reference. I'll choose this edge here. Then once more, I can type in 0.5. Then I can put in my hole specifications. We'll talk more about this in just a little bit. I just want to focus on placement right now. I can go ahead and click OK, and now my hole has been placed. Like other features, I can go back and edit it. I can right click and edit feature, and I can change these dimensions if I want. If I instead wanted to be an inch in, I could do that. Again, I'll undo to bring that back. So that's one way. Let's look at that one more time. You start the hole, you click on a face, you click on an edge you want to dimension from and enter a value, click on another edge and enter a value again, then click OK. Another way that we can place holes is in reference to sketched objects. I'm going to sketch on the top of this rectangular shape. I'm going to project geometry, and then I'm going to use the offset tool to bring that in half an inch. Then I'll finish my sketch. Optionally, I could turn those into construction lines if I wanted to, but I'll go ahead and leave them as object lines for now. If I start my hole command, I can actually snap to sketch geometry. So I can go through here and select multiple points and do all of the holes at once this time if I want. Another way that we can place multiple holes is by using the point tool. I'm going to sketch on this top surface here, and here in the create panel, I'm going to choose the point tool. Then I will go ahead and place multiple points here on top of this shape. Now I want to fully constrain this. So I'm going to add in some horizontal constraints between points as well as some vertical constraints. Then I'm going to bring in some dimensions. So I'll say this is half an inch in, and this one I'll click on the original formula so that it is also half an inch. And then half an inch off of the left side, and then half an inch off of the bottom as well. So a little more work than that offset tool. But the great thing here is that when you start the hole command, the hole tool is automatically going to pick all points. So I didn't even have to select those points. It knew they were points. It placed holes on them. If I didn't want them, I can hold the control key and click on a point to remove them. And then I can click OK. You can very easily create holes in reference to a circular shape. I'll start the hole tool again. And it's basically two clicks. The first click is the face you want it to go on, and the second click is your circular reference. So again, my first click, I'll click somewhere on this top face. Then I will click the circular edge, and it has now created a concentric relationship between the cylinder and the hole. Now that we are familiar with all of the ways to place a hole, let's go in and take a look at many of the options available to us with the hole command. I've already placed a hole here. I'm just going to right click on it and edit feature here in the browser. And we'll take a look at the options here. First of all, the types of holes. We have just a simple hole, We have a clearance hole. We can do threads and have a tapped hole, and then we can have a taper tapped hole as well. We'll look at the tapped hole in just a few minutes. We also can take a look at the seat. So no seat means it's just a straight hole. Otherwise, I can add a counterbore. I can add a spot face, which is very similar. And I can add a countersink with an angle. In addition to those, we have some different options for the termination, which are very similar to the extrude command. I can go through all, I can go a specific distance, and I can go to a specific surface. Notice that when I go either to a surface or a specific distance, I also have the option of deciding if it terminates in a drill point or just a flat surface. Let's look at the counterbore. If I choose the counterbore tool, you can see this area opens up, allowing me to enter in some specific values. I'll go ahead and make this hole go all the way through. Then I can specify a diameter for the counterbore. Let's say it's going to be a half inch. Then I can specify a depth for it as well. We'll say it's going to be a quarter inch. Then I can specify the diameter of the hole itself. So I'll go ahead and bump that up maybe to 3/8. Then I can click OK, and you can now see the hole with the counterbore created. I'm going to back that up and edit it once more, and this time we'll add a countersink instead. I'll choose the countersink option. And here, once more, I've got to give a diameter for the main hole itself, and then a diameter for the top of the countersink. So we'll go half inch on that one. And then instead of a depth, we specify the angle, the included angle of the countersink. Commonly, this will be 82 or 90 degrees. I'll go ahead and just accept 82 for now. And then just to do something different, instead of going completely through the part, I'm going to go a specified distance. We'll say this one only goes in 1 inch, and we want it to terminate at a drill point. And now we can see the hole as created there. I'll change my view style here to shaded with hidden edges so that we can see the hidden lines inside here for the hole. We'll edit this hole once again, and this time we are going to make it a threaded feature. So I'm going to choose the tapped hole option here. When I do this, Inventor is going to access some design data with all the different thread specifications. So I'll first choose my type, then I'll choose my size. The size is going to be driven by the size of the hole that I created already. I can adjust this if I want. Let's say I wanted a half inch. You can see that will go ahead and just adjust the size of the hole for me. Then I have my designation, which includes my pitch and my type of threads. In this case, I've got 13 threads per inch unified national coarse threads. We've got 2B, which is the class of fit, B indicating that it's an internal thread. I can decide if I want it to be right hand or left hand. And then finally, I can decide if the thread is going to go the entire depth or just a specific distance. So in this case, I will choose the full depth check to make sure it threads the entire length of the hole. Then I will go ahead and click OK. Now, as you can see, it creates a hole. It adds a bitmap image to indicate threads. It does not actually cut the threads out. If it did, that would cause many, many surfaces, which would slow down Autodesk Inventor tremendously. So it just uses an image to represent it. I'm going to jump over to a drawing view of this part, and you can see that it does include the hidden lines to indicate the threads. And again, one of the big advantages of doing it this way is I can come in with the hole note and select the hole, and I will get the full call out for the hole based upon the types of threads that I chose. In addition to putting threads in a hole, we can actually add threads to cylindrical surfaces as well. Here on the 3D model tab in the modify panel is the thread tool. I'll select the thread tool and pick on a cylindrical or cone shape. Now, based upon the diameter that was created here, it recognized it was a 3/8 inch diameter, and then it gives me some thread callouts. So once more, I can decide which of these are the ones that I want. I'll go with a 24 threads per inch unified national fine for this one. We're going to get our class of fit, and then it's going to be A because it's an external thread. Then once more, we can adjust the left or right hand as needed. We can also decide if we want the thread to go the full length or a specified distance here as well. I'll go ahead and click OK to create my thread. Once more, this is just a bitmap image, but when I create my drawing file, similar to the hole that we just looked at, I will be able to very easily generate a thread note for this particular feature. That concludes this look at adding holes and threaded features in Autodesk Inventor.